Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to work on this L1800 DTF printer. We're going to remove the waste pump assembly together with the cabin station. At first, we turn on the printer and it's going to move to your left. And then we cut the main power off so we can free the printer carriage. Now we're going to test if the cabin station or waste station is still good or not. So we put a syringe with a tip and we suck ink from the waste tank outlet. You usually have this tube extended towards back, so we can disconnect the extension tube and suck right in the front and just make sure that it's clogged. It's really hard to draw. It seems that we just draw vacuum. We touch the top of the waste pad and it's all wet, so we know the tubes are clogged. We're going to give us some room to work on it. Each printer will be different. They are modified in different ways, so you need to basically remove the casing around it. There are 7 screws that stabilize this cap station on the printer. However, this printer has the front bar removed, so it is missing 2 screws for that front bar. Otherwise, I got a first screw here and a second screw here. I got an unmodified 1800, so I'll just open the gap and peek in. And here's the front bar. And if you have that bar, you're gonna have first screw here and the second screw here. Third screw is deep inside that casing. You will not see the screw from outside. You'll need a long screwdriver and go in and remove the screw. Screw number 4 is top down on the top of the cabin station. And look how wet it is. Because it's clogged, you can suck ink out of it. Okay, we remove screw number 4. Screw number 5 is on the side panel. Screw number 6 is in the back and attached to those orange wires. And the number 7, the final one, is inside that casing. Below the screw on the top. So basically there will be 2 screws in the back, the final 2 screws. This cabin station, it has a motor, so the motor wire is all the way to your right on the main board, and therefore we need to remove this unit with the wire. There are 2 release tabs, one on each side. You can just use your finger, dig it in and release that tab. There are 4 tabs in the back, but I usually just release one side and then see my arm jiggle up and down and it will release itself. Now I'm working on the last tab, the set tab, and I release the set tab and the whole thing can come off. And let me show you the small tabs in the back. So if you want to push it in, just pull, there are 2 left ones and 2 right ones. Just push the tab towards the center like this. And towards the middle, and that will release the tab. But I usually just jiggle up and down, and that will release itself. If you want to remove the duplex, you don't have to remove it. You can loosen it. There will be 1 screw on your right if I'm looking from the back, and there are 2 screws on the left. So 1 screw here, and another screw like in the middle. If you look at the roller. And you're going to see 2 metal brackets on the roller. Find that screw in the back. It's a top screw. There'll be 2 screws, one on the bottom, one on the top. And just remove the top screw. You can take the metal bracket off. This step is optional. It depends on how you guys modify the printer and how easy it is to remove the wire. If the wire is easy to remove, you don't need to take the whole duplexer off. Now we have the whole wire released. Okay, still here. We need to remove this little metal piece. This metal piece is holding the station down. Actually, that's the third screw you removed. And if it's hard to get it out, get a Sharpie. And you can see this plastic, what you call the lever or gear, a mark where that position is, Artisan should have already marked that position. Sometimes they use really thick pin. I want to use a lighter pin, just more precise, mark where it is. And you can remove that screw and then free the hand and remove that metal piece. Actually, that should be the fifth screw and that you removed. And here's the screw hole. Now the cap station is pretty loose. We're going to slide it forward. And to make it easier, we're going to remove a couple screws for the back rail. Also, this modifier put a pad underneath the cabin station. We're going to try to remove that pad. You probably don't have this. And this is a metal pad here. It's easier if you just straighten it, remove this tab. And it's just a useless tab. And now you can slowly just take the cabin station out. This modifier, they put a casing that is raised, so it's really hard to pull it out. So I have to remove two more screws on the top rail, and so I can lift up the rail a little bit and remove the weigh station. Okay, my next video I'll show you how to repair the waste capping station, so you don't need to spend $100 to find a new one. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.